If only there were some awesome, sweet, cool, fast, crazy crash course on Lightroom that took under 16 minutes to learn everything you needed to know to become the Lightroom master of the world. Well, lucky for you, your dreams have come true. All right, so let's dive into Lightroom together. So first, when we open, we have no photos in front of us. Let's hit this import button and scroll to where our photos are kept. You can select whatever hard drive you want. I've got my photos on the desktop, and I'm going to unselect this guy here and hit import. So those photos are going to be imported into what's called my library. And now I'm going to show you another easier way to get photos in. You just find your photos, drag the entire folder into Lightroom, and it will automatically open up that import dialog. You can select which photos that you'd like to import, and you can hit import, or you can apply presets while you're importing, which is very handy. So just go to develop settings, select the preset you want, and then you can apply copyright info to your photo under metadata, or you can apply keywords to the photos so that you already have it sorted and done ahead of time. Very handy. So once that's done, I'm going to hit import. I can choose to select previews built by Lightroom, and that's going to help Lightroom edit the photos faster. But for now, I'm just going to hit minimal so I have them imported as quickly as possible. Once the photos are imported, they're all going to pop up in this library grid. Now there's different views in the library. You can select grid mode, full screen, XYs compare, look at photos before and after, different edits, that sort of thing. On the top left, you've got your navigator panel, which allows you to do things like zoom. It shows which photo you've got actively selected and working on. And then on your right bar, you've got the quick develop panel. This is an awesome panel for developing and editing multiple photos at the same time. So I can apply a preset from here. I can adjust my white balance, apply auto tone controls, exposure settings, that sort of a thing. But what's great about this is I can actually select multiple photos and affect them all at the same time. So if I switch to the grid view here, I'll show you what I mean. They're all selected using the shift key. Then I scroll down, I select a preset, and that preset will be applied across all of those photos. Or if I go to white balance, I can set them all. So this is very handy, especially if you've got multiple photos with similar settings. Say it's all from the same shoot, you apply a batch edit to all of them, and then you go individually and adjust things from there. So Lightroom is organized into different modules, and those are basically different windows for different things. The library window is all about doing batch edits to everything and organizing your photos. So think of a library, things are organized, that's what your library is all about. So I can apply keywords to my images, that helps with the organizing. I can batch edit things. I can adjust the metadata of the photos. So that's basically the information about the actual photo itself. I can change the file name. I can change the title, the caption. I can add a copyright status so that people know this photo is copyrighted by me. And that will actually be exported with the metadata in the photo when you hit save and get it out there. So once I've got that inserted, I can head over to the catalog section and show you all the photos and how they're organized. Catalog shows you all the photos in your library. Folders shows you where those photos are being stored on your computer. Collections allows you to actually create virtual folders inside your library and just sort your images. So let's say I wanted to sort these into a folder. I'd go create collection. I'm going to title it cars and mountains. So now I've got a little folder that has my cars and mountains photos all set there. So the beauty of Lightroom is it lets you do things in different ways. So there's many ways to organize your photos. I'm rating my photos now using the 1 through 5 keys, or if I want to, I can actually color code them as well. So I can apply a star rating, or I can apply a color rating. If you're one of those people who just likes to do yes or no, you can flag it as pick or unpick, and then you can organize all of these things later and sort them depending on how you set your images. So right now, I'm going to just go through and rate a few of them just to show you how quickly I can organize and access these images later in Lightroom. If I go down here and I select 4 stars, I'm going to see all of the photos I've rated 4 stars or higher. Same as if I go through and do 1 star, or if I go rating is equal to 1 star, it'll show me just photos that are rated with 1 star. I can then go through and I can sort them by color, I can sort them by flagged or unflagged, or a combination of the two. So right now I'm showing images with a color as well as 5-star filter. There's more. I can actually sort my images according to camera data, which is amazing. So I can scroll through and I can find photos that were taken just with the GH5, or just with the Olympus EM10, or just with a Nikon D4. The beauty is you can actually select your images and very quickly organize them using the metadata. So I can go through, I can sort them by color, label, star, camera, lens, or by none. So once I've got all of my images organized, what do I do then? Well, I get to go over into the develop panel. So I click develop on the right of library, and that'll actually take me into the image editor inside of Lightroom, the fun stuff. So I'm gonna reset the edits on this image and walk you through how all of this works. I've still got my navigator panel here on the left and then presets underneath it. So you can see how the navigator panel actually displays the preset before I click it, so I can select presets and quickly browse. Now below that, I've got snapshots, which shows my edit processes. Collections, again, is accessible very easily, so I can sort into my car and mountain photo if I want to. Or I can go to my history to select various points of edits during my editing process. Now this right-hand toolbar is where all the power in the develop module lies. At the very top is my histogram. It is going to show me my shadows, my blacks, whites, highlights, exposure. These two little boxes at the left and right actually turn on clipping, which lets me know when an image has too much black in it or too much white in it. Basically, portions of the image that are all white or all black are losing color information and they're gonna show up as red or blue when I have these boxes selected. Very handy when you're editing. Now if I scroll down to my next tools, I'll find the basic panel. This gives me all my basic image adjustments. My white balance, which I can do manually or by setting it to auto, or my exposure, contrast, highlights, shadows, blacks, whites. Below that we have the tone curve, which lets us adjust the brightness of various parts of the image. And you can actually do this with RGB, so it's red, blue, green, or all the values at the same time. Now let's look at one of the most powerful parts of Lightroom, the Hue, Saturation, Luminance panel. This allows me to adjust the hue of any color, the saturation of any color, and the brightness of any color within an image, simply by selecting it and pulling it up or down, using the little tool on the left of Luminance, or by grabbing it manually and adjusting it from there. So by going to the Hue panel and selecting the color of this van, I can click, drag, and change it from baby blue to navy blue in about half a second. How awesome is that? Next, we move into the split toning section of Lightroom, which lets you add a tint to the highlights or the shadows in your image. So with this image, I can adjust and set my highlight to, you know, red, green, yellow, whatever, a nice orange, let's say. And the saturation is going to control how much of that is in the image. I can do the same thing with the shadows by adjusting the saturation or by adjusting the hue, which is the color of that tint. We have the sharpening sections of our image, so we can adjust the amount of sharpening on our image, the radius, which is how thick the sharpening is, and our mask, which is going to adjust how much of the image actually gets sharpening. So our mask at 0 will apply sharpening to everything, at 100 it will only apply sharpening to the strongest edges of the image. So we can zoom in here just by double clicking the image or by clicking the navigator panel, and that will give us a better idea of what's going on in the sharpening. Our next tool is the lens correction panel. So this is very handy for adjusting your photo based on the flaws in your camera or your lens. So typical lenses will have a little bit of vignetting on the edges, a little bit of distortion. So this allows you to set it based on which lens, which camera you took it with, and adjust it from there manually if you need to. Our transform panel is for a very similar purpose. Let's say that you were slightly off center when you took a picture of this van. Well, you can adjust that using the horizontal transform tool. Or if you were pointing too high, too low, you weren't directly level with your camera, you can adjust that too by tilting the photo forward or backwards. This is a very handy tool when you're just slightly off and your photo needs a quick tweak. Moving into effects, we have vignette, which we can add or take away, set the midpoint, that sort of a thing, and then we have grain, so we can make our image look like it was shot on film. So you can go crazy with that. I would prefer to go subtle so that you can't really notice it. At the very bottom here, we have camera calibration, which basically is telling your computer, telling Lightroom, how to interpret the color of your photo. So you can select the different camera profiles that you shot your photo on, or you can manually adjust how Adobe is interpreting the reds, the greens, the shadows, the blues, and you can tweak things from there. So our signature edit profiles use different camera calibrations to get different looks in the hopes of making it look more like a film camera. So let's say I apply a couple presets to an image and I want to decide which one I like better. Well, I can create what's called a virtual copy and apply my preset to each of them, get two different edits, and then I can compare them by going back into my library panel and hitting this XY button at the bottom grid. And that will actually show me both versions compared side by side. I can zoom in by hitting the fit or fill button and see which edit I like better. So I like the one on the left better, but I don't like how desaturated it is. So once I've got it kind of set where I want it to be, I'm going to take those settings and actually paste it onto the other copy of this image. I'm going to go Control C or Command C depending on PC or Mac, and then I'm going to paste it onto the one on the left here. Lastly, we have our tools at the very top here, and these are the specialized tools. So image by image, I'll edit things like my crop, go in and use the spot heal tool or clone tool, and that's going to allow me to very quickly remove blemishes, loose hairs, maybe camera dust from my image, small little things. So I'm going to zoom in here on the model's face, and if I look very closely, I can see just a few little blemishes that I'm going to take care of by selecting them with the spot heal tool. And Lightroom is automatically going to find another area of similar color and use that to clone over those little blemishes. We're going to skip over the red eye tool here and go into our graduated filters, which lets us apply a filter across an area of an image from highest intensity all the way down to zero. So I can adjust things like my exposure, I can darken parts of the image to draw attention to another area. So let's say I wanted to emphasize this cloud that's in front of her. Well, I can take my clarity down, my exposure up, my white balance tweak a little bit, and it'll look like it's a lot thicker. Or I can press delete at any time and get rid of it. Beside that, we have our radial filter, which is the same thing, only using an ellipse slash circle, with the center being the strongest point, the outside being the weakest. If I press quotation, it will actually invert that, so I can darken or lighten the background or my subject in the photo. And lastly, we have our adjustment brush, which is pretty much my favorite part of Lightroom. I can take her hair, paint over it with an adjustment brush, and brighten it in about 2 seconds. To adjust the adjustment brush, you just scroll down here, and I can adjust things like the size, the feather, which is how hard or soft the brush is, the flow, which is how fast the effect comes out, the density, which is the maximum amount of effect applied. The most beautiful part about adjustment layers is you can have as many as you want. So you just scroll to the top, hit new, and you've got another one. So let's edit an image together. First, I'm going to apply my image. Then I'm going to select auto white balance, scroll down, and adjust my exposure to a level that I think is practical. So I'm liking the way that this image is looking. I'm just going to slightly tweak the highlights, bring the shadows up ever so slightly, bring some more saturation into the photo. But what's bugging me is these two people off in the grass here. Well, let's see if we can use the spot tool to remove them. I'm going to paint over, and Lightroom will automatically select an area to replace it with, but that wasn't accurate, so I can just click and drag it over, and just like that, man number one is gone. I'm going to just do the same thing over here with woman number two, paint over that, and Lightroom again is going to auto-select, and sometimes it doesn't do the best job. So I'm just going to select a different area of the image here, and just like that, person number two is almost hidden, but kind of not good enough for me. I'm going to try and tweak some different settings here, but it doesn't look good. So if it doesn't work for you, all you do is hit it, hit delete, and start again. So I'm going to make my brush a little bigger this time to cover her completely. And there we go. Right away, it pretty much covered her up. So how much better is that? I'm actually going to create a virtual copy here, pressing Command apostrophe, and just to show you exactly where we came from, here's before, and here's after. How great is that? So there's a couple things I'd still like to do with this image. One is to emphasize the sky a little bit. So I'm going to drag this graduated filter down, and I'm not going to make it that extreme, just a little bit darker, and then I'm going to add some blue to it in the white balance, and that's just going to make it pop a little bit more. Now I'm going to take this building and darken it just the slightest bit using a radial filter. I'll take that, press the apostrophe key to invert it, and darken it ever so slightly. Subtle is the best choice of action here, so just a tiny bit, bringing the highlights down, the exposure ever so slightly, and the whites down to make sure that nothing is clipping and everything is looking good. Lastly, I'm going to brighten it up a little bit, and then paint with an adjustment layer on this grass just to bring out some more detail and texture in the photo. So, first thing I'm going to do is paint over all of this grass. I'm just going to click, hold, and paint, and you can see it's getting a little bit darker. And after that, I'm going to take the clarity up, add some dehaze maybe, a little bit of sharpening, and some highlights, some whites, just put a little more contrast in that grass. And you can see how it's popping already and adding some interest and detail to the image. Lastly, I'm going to go up to this white balance, add a little bit of warmth to that grass, and maybe, not magenta, let's add some green back into it, just so it looks a little more grass-like. Now I'm going to press the O key, and that's going to show me where I've actually painted my adjustment layer. And you can see that I've actually missed a few spots, so I'm just going to touch those up. And I'm going to focus a little bit, add another adjustment layer onto the sky. Just brighten those clouds up and make them pop out of the image. So take my brush, set the exposure a little bit higher, highlights a little bit higher, clarity. And I've still got the O key enabled, so that's going to paint as red so I can see it very easily. There we go. And I'm going to paint one cloud at a time, just very roughly, very quickly for the sake of this video. And it's going to show you hopefully how quick and fast Lightroom can be when you know what you're doing. So you see how there's these little spots in here? Well, that's because I had auto mask on. I'm going to turn it off. And now we are painting without Lightroom trying to figure out what areas I'm actually painting and just painting on everything that I touch. So I'm going to go over these clouds here very quickly. And once that's done, I'll just press O and I can see what my mask is looking like in reality. Oh wow, so it looks like we're not that subtle. I'm gonna take that down and just very slightly get rid of the exposure, add a little bit of highlights. Mostly I'm concerned about adding some clarity, some texture to these clouds. So I'll take the clarity up and just see how we're doing there. So very slightly, bring some highlights into it, and I can always press delete and very quickly see what it was before and after by pressing Command Z or Control Z on a PC. Just cycle back and forth and it's looking good. I'm gonna dial it back just a little bit because we always want it to be subtle. You don't want it to be obvious. And we're looking pretty good. Dial the contrast on the whole image back. Bring the vibrance up ever so slightly and the saturation down. That's generally a good rule of thumb. Vibrance is the saturation of the mid-tones. Saturation is saturation on all the colors in the image, shadows and highlights included, which makes it look a little bit less natural. So I've got that where I want it. Some of my edits are done. Let's export some photos. I'm gonna go to File, Export. That'll bring up the export dialog. I can either select a preset on the left or I can set my settings manually. Put them in a subfolder once the images are finished. Let's just title this Best Image Ever. Rename, I can set it to a custom name or any number of things. So let's set in a custom text here. Set my compression size. I can have the image be smaller than 800 kilobytes or I can have it be full size. I can resize to fit the width and height dimensions. Long edge. Long edge is this edge down here. The longest edge on an image. Short edge is the short edge on the image. So it'll make that edge as long as you want it to be. Width and height, or I normally go with long edge and set it to 2048. That's the best for Facebook settings right now. And we can add a watermark if we want to. We won't right now. And once we've got all that dialed in the way we want to, we'll hit export and Lightroom will show its progress in the top left corner. And once it's done, it will open up our photos automatically in Finder or on a PC, whatever window you've set it to. Okay, great. So there they are. Looking good. So let's say you want to add a watermark, you just go to Lightroom, edit watermark, and you can add your watermark either in a JPEG or just with text. All these settings are pretty straightforward. You type them in and you've got your watermark just like that.
Congratulations, you're officially a Lightroom master. How does it feel? Hey, thanks so much for watching this video. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more awesome creative content. And to download your free Lightroom presets, head to signatureedits.com. All right, peace.